Now, the most accurate weather forecast in South Texas with meteorologist Juan Acuna.
Welcome back, everyone, and a happy peak of the week to you. We're taking a live look at our Aztec Chevrolet 6 weather bug off in Beeville. We have clear skies. It's warm out there. 88 degrees, southwesterly winds at 3 miles an hour. 83 over in Kingsville as we look at our Nissan Automotive 6 weather bug. A few more clouds are holding on to that region there. East southeasterly winds at 14 miles an hour. Even our water temperature out at the Packery Channel warmed up into the lower 80s this afternoon, but it's as high as 88. Off in Falfurrias, and of course our winds continue to be out of the south southeast, a little breezy near the coastline as always, around 10 to 20 miles per hour. Of course, that's helping pump in plenty of moisture off of the Gulf of Mexico, so our dew points are very, very healthy out there, and it is feeling like 96 degrees off in Falfurrias. It feels like 91 here in Corpus Christi, 92 out at the Naval Air Station, and the middle to upper 80s right along the coastline from Rockport down to Port Aransas. So with all that extra moisture in the air, yes, we're going to have another round of some fog early in the morning. That will drop visibilities down to about 1 to 2 miles. Use caution. Our evening forecast shows temperatures falling into the middle to upper 70s about 10 o'clock this evening with south southeasterly winds around 5 to 10 miles per hour. But for now, all the cloud coverage that we have earlier today has now burned off, and we have mainly clear skies over South Texas. But there is our frontal boundary up to the north. It's going to be meandering back and forth. It almost looks like it's going to arrive for tonight, but it's not. I'm going to show you why in just a second. We have much colder temperatures up to the north of us as high pressure. That's where it's at. And you can see the temperatures are into the middle to lower 20s up in the northern plains. And yeah, we're going to get a taste of some of that. Not 20s, not 30s, but we are going to cool down into the 50s, though. Here's why, though. As we look at the water vapor imagery, upper levels of the atmosphere, here's what we have going on. We have a zonal flow. This is what we call, in meteorological terms, everything is flowing from west to east. Nothing is moving on down to the south. In other words, we don't have a push to get this cold air down to the south. Where is that push? There it is right there. We need that to come down into the central plains, and that will happen as we go into tomorrow afternoon. So that's going to be enough push that we need to get that frontal boundary that's stuck in central Texas all the way through the coastal bend. And that's going to happen on Friday morning for us here. You can see it go right on by, but it doesn't dig a whole lot. Then watch what happens as we go into Saturday. Yet another disturbance off into the Pacific Northwest. This one is going to dig a little bit farther down to the south, and we're really going to get in on some colder air. We have high pressure that's going to be off to the western coast of the United States. That's really going to get some of this cold air that's up into the Arctic, up into Canada, and shoot it all the way down into South Texas. In fact, it's going to blow through the entire state, and much of the country is going to be pretty cold as we go by to the middle and end of next week. But again, we're going to get our shot of some cooler weather as we go on into the end of the week and on into the weekend as well. In the meantime, though, for tomorrow, it's still going to be into the upper 80s, mainly cloudy, humid. Some isolated showers will be in the forecast. Let's look at it on the future tracker. This frontal boundary could enter the northern sections of the coastal bend as we go into tomorrow. That's around Three Rivers, George West, Beeville. You folks might get slightly not as hot temperatures. Instead of the middle to upper 80s, we'll look at the lower 80s in the afternoon. Just a couple of little isolated showers. Then there comes a big push right there. That frontal boundary will go through, and we're going to be looking at windy and cooler conditions as we head on into the weekend. Our NEC Co-op Energy 7-day forecast, 86 tomorrow. Then there comes a front. We're only talking about the 50s, scattered and numerous thunder showers on Friday, staying cool on Saturday. And yes, another front early Monday. That'll send temperatures to the coldest of the season by Tuesday and Wednesday morning, Paulo.